I understand your pain and appeal to you to consider the offer put forward by the Chief Minister, All India Majlis-e Tehsil Muslimeen Chief Asaduddin Owaisi said. Hyderabad Prime Minister and All India Majlis-e Tehsil Muslimeen President Asaduddin Owaisi reacted to the ongoing strike by workers of the Telangana State Road Transport Corporation on Saturday night. He was speaking hours after the state government, led by Chief Minister K. Chandrasekhar Rao, announced the privatization of 5,100, or 50%, of real-time clock routes in the state. The decision came in response to the ongoing indefinite strike by over 48,000 employees, demanding the Telangana State Road Transport Corporation's merger into the government. Addressing a gathering in Hyderabad, Owaisi said, "I understand your pain and appeal to you to consider the offer put forward by the Chief Minister. It is very unfortunate that some workers of the real-time clock have killed themselves during the ongoing strike. Don't take your lives. Please consider and accept the proposal put forward by the CM and sit for talks with the government. Do not get swayed by Congress and Bharatiya Janata Party leaders. This land is yours, Telangana belongs to you," he added, expressing hope that the deadlock is broken soon. Owaisi also had a special request for the Chief Minister. "I urge Chief Minister K. Chandrasekhar Rao that though he is privatizing the real-time clock, the Z in the number plates of real-time clock buses must not be removed, as it comes from the name of Zehra, the mother of Mayor Osman Ali Khan, the last Nizam of Hyderabad. It is a part of Hyderabad's history," he said. Meanwhile, Kalvakuntla Chandrasekhar Rao, who has been unwilling to hold talks with the employees, issued an ultimatum to the striking workers to resume their duties in the next 3 days. "If they don't return to work by November 5th midnight, we will privatize remaining 5,000 routes," he said. Kalvakuntla Chandrasekhar Rao said the decision to privatize the routes was irrevocable as the state was empowered to do so under the Motor Vehicles Act, 2019.